Okay, so today is the topic electrical instruments and meters. Now, as in the last video lecture, I told that the electrical instrument is one of the very important constituents for power system instrumentation. And the basic thing from where we will start, actually digital voltmeter. So in digital voltmeter, what we can measure? We can measure voltage, we can measure current, if we want we can measure power also, and of course with that we can measure resistance, capacitance and inductance also. In this digital voltmeter there will be a panel, the instrument is just like this. As you are already known, as it is already known to you, there is a pointer and all other things are given over here. Here is the terminal, that means one for positive, one for negative. In this panel we will get 7 segment display. Now this is the basic diagram of digital voltmeter. This is the panel, that's why we are sharing this thing. This thing is the panel. This is the pointer. One portion is for voltage, one portion is for current, one another portion is for resistance, for capacitance, for inductance, for transistors, for diode, and for various other like frequency and etc. So like this, the digital voltmeter will be working. Now what we will measure? Suppose we can measure from a small circuitry to a large circuitry, we can measure these parameters. Voltage, current, power, etc. We are knowing that voltage can be expressed in terms of volt or millivolt. Current can be expressed in terms of milliampere, ampere or microampere. Power can be expressed in terms of watts or millivolts. So these are the things for digital voltmeter. Now, as you are knowing very well, there are various type of torque by which it will be controlled. There will be controlling torque, there will be deflection torque, these are the main two type of things which will actually indicate. Of course, these are the constituent parts for analog voltmeter previously, which will actually control, that means what will be the pointer indication, that means how much the angular distance the pointer will travel. In digital voltmeter, of course, the same thing will be there, but whatever be the reading we are getting, that will be on the digital panel only. Now, apart from this digital voltmeter, LCR meter is there also, with calibration, with proper calibration and justification LCR meter also, where we can measure inductance, capacitance and resistance for any basic type of components. Various companies are there who are manufacturing LCR meter. Apart from these two, there is Q meter. Quality factor along with other basic parameters, it will give us the result, it will show the measurements of all those things. Q meter is also a very important thing. Now, whenever we are talking about all those things, instrumentation amplifier will be also coming over there. And we can see all these things will be used basically if we can tell about power meter also, that thing will be there. So all those things will be basically used for, all those instruments and meters will be basically used for measuring. Now, I am coming to the basic thing. And what is this basic thing? Electrical instrument and meter. So just see over here that in this case, whenever we are talking about electrical instruments and meters, as process control is a very important thing which is guiding power system instrumentation. And we have seen there are four hands of process control. One is flow, one is temperature, one is pressure, and the fourth one is level. It will be in conjugation with electrical instruments. When we will come to flow, it will be of area type, it will be of, one is area type, and one is lengthwise or volume one. Now, which are the meters that will guide flow type? When we will consider the flow meter, in conjugation with power system, there will be various, like there will be orifice, there will be various classifications of orifice. It may be concentric, it may be eccentric, it may be segmented. So we are knowing this thing as you students, you are knowing concentric, eccentric, or segmented type of orifice. What they will do actually based on Bernoulli's theorem, they will just see the pressure difference between the upstream and downstream, and then the fluid will flow. Of course, there are some flow meters which is depending on area also. We are knowing that particular type of paper in tube, which is the particular, it is just like this, the mass will be over here, it is just like that particular flow meter. So now whenever we are considering about flow meter, as we are knowing there will be Peter tube also, there will be Venturi meter also, so all these things will be in conjugation with process control. Now the question is, then how it is being conjugated with electrical instruments and meters in a power system? Of course, there will be some particular pneumatic phenomenon by which we are knowing P to I converters, I to B converters, B to I converters, P to B converters, like this. Pressure to current, pressure to voltage, voltage to pressure, voltage to current, current to voltage, like that one. So, as you are seeing over here, that all those things will be working on the same principle, that is on Bernoulli's theorem. That means the upstream and downstream we have to see the pressure difference, and by that, depending on that pressure difference, the fluid will flow. Now the main question is this, after this flow, what else will come? Of course there will be ultrasonic flow meter also. Apart from ultrasonic flow meter, there will be mass Coriolis flow meter, magnetic flow meter, etc. Apart from this, we are going about temperature. In temperature, starting from bimetallic strip, there will be thermocouple, there will be RTD, that is the resistance temperature detector, there will be thermistor, etc. Of course, this RTD and thermistor, they are known as PTC and NTC, that means positive temperature coefficient and negative temperature coefficient. So, of course, here, what is the main thing? They are working on Peltier effect, Peltier effect and Thomson effect. As you are aware of CJT effect, Peltier effect and Thomson effect, well-known effect, all those things already you learned in your undergraduate and of course in the first standard, so it is needless to say all those things. But the main thing is this, here whatever will be the output, that output will be in terms of voltage. Whatever is the change in temperature, that particular resolution we will get in terms of voltage. For this measurement, if we will come to pressure, then also we can see there will be, of course, for pressure. As I told you, the flow is depending on area, volume or length. Pressure, that is also a particular thing that is depending on this area or length. Of course, there also we are seeing various types of things like this P-dot tube will be there, the pressure difference. Actually, flow and pressure, they are very much closely related to each other. There we will see again Bernoulli's theorem will be holding on. And for pressure also we will see orifice, there will be the classification of orifice, like one will be concentric, one will be eccentric, one will be segmented, there will be area type pressure measure, there will be another type of pressure measure, like as in case of mass Coriolis flow meter, we have seen that it is depending on the mass of the fluid that will be flowing through a particular channel, like that. So pressure is also depending on Bernoulli's theorem. So flow and pressure is very closely related with each other. There will be level. Of course, capacitor type of level sensor will be there, ultrasonic type of level sensor will be there. So all those things are very much closely related to process control, because this thing, actually what it will do, it will convert pressure to current, current to pressure, pressure to voltage, voltage to pressure, like that. P2I pneumatic transmitter will be there, which will convert some particular pressure value, maybe it will be in bar or millibar, or maybe it will be in PSI or PSIC or exactly, Pascal in gauge, and of course PSI is actually possibly PA is Pascal. It will be converting that pressure to current in terms of milliampere. So this is the basis of all these things. That means for flow, temperature, pressure and level, whatever I want to tell you, that of course for all of them, whatever be the output, that output at that output position, there will be some valve positioner, there will be some valve controller by which we can control the fluid flow, and thereafter we will get the converted output through transmitter as well as transducer. So in case of electrical instruments and meters, it is needless to say that it is a very important type of thing which you can get endeavor of, in which you will be very much aware that electrical instruments and meters are very much useful for all types of power system, wherever in industry or say in household. Now, if I will come to the apart from classification, working principle of application, if I will come to what will be the scope of application for future, for prospective, then I can tell you that this electrical instrument and meter, they can be used in terms of telemetry also. As I told you before also, that in telemetry, there are different types of things. There will be voltage telemetry, there will be current telemetry, there will be power telemetry, there will be time telemetry, etc. So, telemetry is a particular thing which is closely related with electrical instruments. Closely related with electrical instruments and meters. So telemetry is a very important type of thing, because tele is the meaning of long distance. That means to a long distance, whatever your data that will go from a local position to a remote position, of course remote position controller will be there also, but we should be aware of these terms, because this will give you the essence. That means whenever you are doing some particular operations, whenever there will be some particular functionalities within a power system or outside the power system, telemetry is a very important type of thing. As I told you before also, that telemetry is subdivided into 4 to 5 categories depending on the working principle, characteristics and applications. So, in case of electrical instruments and meters, this is the very important scope that we can get the future endeavor with. Now, the question is, how can an user handle the interference that I'm video lecture? Hello? Haan, bol na, bol na. How can an user handle the interference for electrical instruments? This is the big question. Whenever there will be any type of electrical instrument that we are dealing with, the question is coming over there. Number one, there will be various types of noises or various types of factors that we should remove. The first one is very important. Just try to listen to this. The first one is the inherent error. There will be various types of errors. Of course, the first error is the parallelness error. We are knowing this thing very well, that is on a scale, whenever we are seeing some data, if we will see from an angle, we will get different data. But if we are standing perpendicular and we are seeing like this, then we will see that exact thing. That is the parallelness error. Of course, you can say that is the human error. Number two, from error only then I will go to interference. Number two, there will be systemic error, which is the inherent thing in an instrument. Now, systemic error is coming due to several factors. Number one, if there will be no proper calibration or adjustment. Number two, if there will be extensive effect of outer environment. Number three, if there will be aging effect present with the instrument. What is this aging effect that will be present with the instrument? If suppose the particular instrument, if that particular thing is an older one, then what will happen? There will be several types of things. And the fourth one is the instantaneous one. There may be any kind of random error. Because whenever with some particular measuring instrument we are measuring some parameter, then we can see that there will be some transient error. In case of digital panel vision, we can see over there that there will be flickering. That means the particular value which is in the transient state, after certain time interval it will come to a stable state. Until that time there will be some flickering. So of course there will be some type of error which is known as transient error, and of course there will be some type of error that is related with this known as steady state error. After that, of course, there will be some random error. As I told you before also, noise is a particular unwanted signal. How much will be the effort that we are doing just to eradicate or to remove the noise? We cannot remove or eradicate it completely. We may do the Gaussian distribution of noise, or we may do any other type of statistical probability for noise. We cannot remove that particular thing. There may be a chunk of random noise which we can average also, but then also the effect of noise will be present over there. Now the question is, then how we will get some particular reading which will be 100% true value? Of course that is not possible. We can optimize the value because there will be some error which we cannot completely eradicate, but we can optimize the error. Suppose in case, as you are knowing also in master degree student, suppose in case we have to get some value as 5 volts, instead of that we are getting the value as 4.95 volts. So there is an error of 0.05. After extensive work also, we are getting the value of 4.99, 0.01 error is there, which we cannot eradicate or cannot remove. So then we have to do the round of operation and we have to measure that thing as, or we have to get that thing as 5 volts. Are you getting my point? So completely removal of error is not possible, because we can do the averaging, we can do the statistical probability operation, we can do the Gaussian distribution, but completely we cannot eradicate this thing. Is it clear? Now the question is, then the question of interference will be coming over there. There will be two types of interference, as I told in my last video lecture. There will be constructive type of interference, there will be destructive type of interference. In case of constructive type of interference, we will get a conjugated effect. That means, whatever be the value, that will be enhanced. Suppose, I am giving a very, very common example. Suppose, in presence of, there are 1000 people sitting in an auditorium, and you are delivering some speech without any public address system. Maybe, first 50 people who are sitting very near to your dais, they can hear you, but others cannot. Maybe there will be some external environmental factor will be present, because 1000 people are sitting, being of silence, of course, that may be possible, but that is an ideal case. In real case, of course, there will be some type of whispering and all those things will be there. So, of course, there will be some types of random noise that will be present over us. So, how you can eradicate that particular type of thing? That particular type of thing you can eradicate by the use of public address system, by the use of cordless mic or handheld mic, or by use of some type of other old mics like this thing. You are just putting that thing in front of your mouth and just deliver the speech whatever you want to. So in that case, what will happen? The source signal will get interfered with other signal, but it will make a constructive interference so that enhanced value you will get. The listener will listen the enhanced value. Of course, there will be destructive type of interference also. And in case of destructive type of interference, what will happen? You will get the diminished value. That means it's a type of Doppler effect also. You are knowing this thing very well, that one particular listener is or observer is present on a station, and the train is approaching by giving whistle, and when the train will receive away, you can hear the whistle very slowly or very dimly, but when it is approaching to you, you can hear it very loudly. It's that type of thing. So, you have to handle this interference, you have to optimize the interference just to get a very clear result. So, this is the particular thing for electrical instruments and meters. Of course, after this, PLCC, microwave link, transmission link, optical link, all those things will be coming. Power system instrumentation, in power system instrumentation, whatever output we will get, we have to use of wired channel, of course, through wireless, if you have to just disperse some data or communicate some data, we can transfer it by Ethernet also. So, these are the things which is very, very important for electrical instruments and meters. Now, this is a particular type of thing, that how can an user handle the interference for electrical instruments which I have just discussed now, and it is a very important thing, a very important aspect if we will optimize this interference. Of course, after that, yesterday I have given you some idea about programmable logic control, about supervisory control and data acquisition, about direct digital control, about process control, about distributed control system. So all those things will be coming one after another, which are the integral part of power system and instrumentation. Now, whenever we are talking for power system and instrumentation, please be very careful in listening that we have to handle several outside factors. We have to optimize them, just like noise or interference, which are unwanted in nature. So by this, we have just finished the overview, the classification of electrical instruments and meters. Now we can come to the working principles. In my next video lecture, I will cover the working principles of electrical instruments and meters along with their graphical representation, along with their scope of application, what will be their advantages and disadvantages. And after that, of course, all those things, PLC, microwave links, SCADA, DCS, BDC, all those things will come one after another, where we will just consider about first the overview, then we will consider about overview and introduction, then what will be the next thing, we will consider about the working principles. After that, the third one will be the classification. The fourth one will be the advantages and disadvantages, and the fifth one will be scope of application. So this will be just like this, one after another it will be coming. So this complete actually the overview for electrical instruments and meters. So